Hello, and welcome to This Week I Tried, aka TWIT, the occasionally weekly show where I dig in through my indie backlog and play some titles that look interesting and talk about them for a bit. This week I'm looking at Momodora, Reverie Under the Moonlight. It is apparently the fourth installment in, quote, a beloved series of 2D platformers, end quote. I did not know that there were more titles, and I don't think they're all available on Steam, unfortunately, but I am going to have to track them down because this is delightful. It was developed by Bombservice and published by Playism, and Bombservice is a Brazilian development studio, and they seem to focus on, like, developing games that are very retro feeling. They're very much inspired by classics. I think their website, it might be Google, but I think it was their website, references Cave Story, Castlevania, and Zelda. And yeah, I get those vibes. And it was actually founded, Bombservice was actually founded by a single guy, I believe, Guillaume Martin, and he actually self-published the first three titles. So that's friggin' awesome and good on him on being able to continue this. It's great. It was originally released in March 14th, 2016, and I got it on Steam for like $10. You can probably find it on sale for cheaper. It is also available on previous generation consoles, so PS4, Xbox One, and then you can also find it on the Switch. Yeah, even if you have to pay full price of $10, I would definitely say it is worth it. So first things first, we have to deal with our settings. Nothing's terribly crazy in settings. You can actually, when you first boot it up, it's usually a very small window, at least has been for me. And so you have to adjust if you want it full screen. Graphical quality, it's pretty just low, medium, high. Same thing with controller type. I use the default controls, but if you want to roll with the bumper and melee or ranged with B, you can. I believe that's the only thing that changes, yeah. And then there is a keyboard, and you can customize your keys, but I just use the default controls. It feels good in a 2D action platformer like this. So we're going to go ahead and jump in. So the deal with this game is that you are this priestess Kaho, and you wield a bow and this enchanted leaf. And well, the world is dying and corrupted, and evil is spreading, so you are trying to, gain an audience with the queen and convince her to use her power to help save the world. Ha ha ha. But I don't know, I feel like if she had the power to save the world, she already would, so I'm kind of concerned for the health of the queen. We'll see. But, so some things of note, I guess. Things that I like to point out are that clearly the pixel art is... Oh, where am I? What am I doing? Oh no. I didn't want to get to a boss fight this soon. Gosh darn it, I don't... That's so frustrating that... Oh gosh. Alright, we're gonna heal again. Is there anything else I need to do with you? Okay, there is. Well, I hoped to talk more before getting into a boss fight. Gosh darn it, I'm gonna die anyways. Okay, I thought I ducked. Oh well. We'll come back to that after I've explored a bit more, I guess. That was surprising. All right, so the pixel art is very pretty, as is the, you know, I think the character designs are great. Like, I mean, look at her. Look at her. Ah, gosh darn it. Of course, I rolled out of the room and caused a respawn. Look how cute that is. She got a nice bounce. I think if you sit and wait for a bit, yeah, she does like a nice yawn. It's a really nice just idle pose. And people that are good at pixel art, it just astounds me because I don't get that. You can see her lifting up her heels and lowering them back down. Like, that's to like help give that bob. That's incredible. The leaf combos, I think, look so great. They do a really good job of like smearing it and having those particles kind of come off it, which, like, the smear clearly so you can like read it better, but something about the particles flying off of it just feels very leafy, I guess. And then there's a nice wind up and delay to that final hit. And I think if you hit an enemy with the final hit, it might pause for a couple frames to like really emphasize the intensity of the hit, which is like, it's great. Bow is much more just instantaneous. Although you can charge it and then fire. Okay, I get that. I was about to say, I kind of want her to be like, charging the bow back to gain the energy. But if it's going to let me hold the energy and do other attacks before unleashing the... Oh. Yeah. Do other attacks before unleashing the bow? I think it did. Yeah. Cool. I don't know why it canceled out that one time I tried to show you guys. I guess it makes sense that she wouldn't actively hold the bow if you can hold the charge like that. But that's just a nitpick of mine. Bonus points, you don't need to worry about not being able to breathe underwater. I have stood in these sections for a decent amount of time just to see if anything happens. Nope, you can breathe underwater, thereby ending one of the horrible, horrible things that occurs in most games with water. Hello, person. No one wants to be in this forsaken city any longer. Our entire kingdom feels like a grave. The death count keeps going up daily. I don't have much left other than the memory of my sister, Catherine. Also, can we just talk about this jump back bounce that she settles to talk to people? Yeah, it's just cute. To like put her in a good distance to like a good talking distance. I don't know. I think it's a really cute touch. So the controls feel pretty good as well. I think they're just as responsive as they need to be. Like they're not terribly twitchy, but they're also not like they're responsive. They're very good responsive. It feels a lot like for whatever reason, maybe it's just the different realms, different like castle areas that's making me feel it, but it does make me feel kind of like a non roguelike Rogue Legacy. Just because, I don't know, I'm exploring different wings of a castle with some, 2D action and platforming controls. Yeah, there you are. I knew you were coming. Okay. Fine. Jerk. Actually, I don't want to go that way, because that way is dangerous. Just trust me. Trust me. So, on Steam, this game has actually gotten enough tags for it also to be listed as a Metroidvania and a Souls-like. And I both agree and disagree with that. Oh gosh, I didn't realize there were two of them. I agree in the sense, like, well, let's start with Metroidvania. Like, this is definitely built on kind of a Metroidvania style map. You see, map completion is a big deal. I found some secrets and there's a lot of open exploration and kind of backtracking to figure out what you're supposed to do. Stop. I don't want you. But like, the gameplay doesn't feel like a Metroidvania to me. Like I mentioned, it feels kind of like Rogue Legacy. It has very, like, the controls are, I wouldn't call the controls twitchy, but they feel twitchier than I would expect from like a Metroidvania. If that makes any sense at all. And like, it definitely starts, like, you definitely play on a Metroidvania style map, but the gameplay feels different, partially because I don't think you really progress the same way you do in a Metroidvania. Like, yeah, get out of here. Whoops. I was facing the wrong way for that combo. Like, I've gotten items here and there, but it's mostly been some incremental health upgrades and these guys, these ivory bugs, which I don't know what they're for yet. And none of those items have helped my abilities or mobility. So, like, you know, I hate this place. Just gonna try to dodge our way through. All right, close enough. Like in Metroidvania, in Metroid, there are like area, you know, as you get more items, more of the map opens up to you. You know, you like there are certain doors you come across where you definitely have bombs, you know, or like if you get bomb, you definitely need bombs to get through, or you need super missiles to unlock this door. And, you know, even in Hollow Knight, where, you know, once you get the Mantis Claw or some of the other, you know, just things that help you scale walls more, it's like, oh, this, you know, this opens up some options for me. So that hasn't felt quite the same. It feels, and the fact that it's mostly like incremental health, and then I guess these items in the upper left are some other things I've found, which is the equipment. And you have some nice flavor text with them. Kind of helps fill in the back lore, but we'll get back. We'll return to that in a moment. But it's kind of like playing Hollow Knight and just finding, like, the most of the map being open to you immediately, and you just finding, oh gosh, did I want to drop down there? Oh, I've been here before. Oh, thank goodness. So it feels like the, like, if you played that just with charms or, you know, just with health upgrades and finding charms. Come on, gotta shoot you. There we go. And, yeah, so it's just, it feels different because there's not the same type of progression as far as mobility and such. Also, regarding a Souls-like, I get that, and I don't get that. I get it in the little touches, like I talked about the items. That looks like that might be something important. Because, you know, look at my equipment here, the maple leaf. It has, like, some nice lore description thrown in there, which feels very Dark Souls. Although I must say, sharp enough to purify enemies is a, it's not the best description I would give to something that a priestess is supposed to wield, but, you know, kind of funny. So, like, there are details like that where you get lore and stuff that it does feel like, oh, this is, oh gosh, you jerk. Just feels like Dark Souls stuff, but again, like with, you know, 2D platformer controls, the, you know, the twitchier action, it doesn't feel like Souls-like combat at all. I have gotten a new item. Magnet stone. Okay. What is magnet stone? Attracts money stars. Okay. I mean, I don't need it to... Both of those are regards to money. The little sparkly gem things that I'm picking up. Is there anything that... Actually, I don't want to jump that way if, That was almost dumb of me to bypass that. It's okay. I'm gonna find the bell is that way. Alright. Alright, so we're just gonna just take some shots. Hope for that. There. Oh. That was me fat thumbing the jump button and accidentally hitting the roll button. So I gotta go back and get that item again. Because gosh darn it, I'm getting that item. You know what? Screw you all. There we go. Alright. So, I guess from here, I'll just move on to, like, my likes and dislikes. Just right off the bat. I don't know. Oh, you jerk. Oh gosh, I can knock his bombs back at him. That's a nice touch. That is really cool. So, as far as likes, like, I don't even know where to begin, because it's just, I don't know, the game's just a delight to me. I really enjoy it a lot. The, as I mentioned, the art is cute. Like, look at the freaking leaf puffs that come behind on the double jump. Like, little touches like that are just so cute and well done. I love it. Oh, wait, did I just step on a platform accidentally? What am I catching on? What am I standing on? Oh, tell me there are invisible platforms somewhere in this world. What if I go this way? Nope. Hold on, I'm gonna give it one more go. Oh, man. That's gonna get me. That's gonna bug me. Oh, well. So, the art is super pretty. The gameplay is just as snapping responsive as I want it to be. And a couple of the bosses did kind of annoy me, but like I still liked them. They were still interesting to me. Gosh darn it, I'm not doing great. There we go. Like they still were well designed, you know? Gotta make sure I'm going the right direction. Oh gosh. Back dog. Yes, I am going the right direction. Good. But yeah, there's just a lot to really love about it, and it's hard to, like, look at this. That just feels very Castlevania. I love it. It looks great. As far as dislikes go, it's it's mostly nitpicks, I think. Like, as of this point, the exploration doesn't feel quite as rewarding as I want it to. Part of that is just based in the fact that I haven't found much of anything other than money or little minor health increases when the exploring happens. And I don't know, I guess I just want the secrets to be a bit more meaningful. Another dislike, everyone's terrible. Gosh darn it. Everyone's terrible. I hate everyone. All right. Cheese and crackers, I'm not doing great. Just gotta take her down. Yeah, because I didn't want these things to fall on me as I'm trying to fight her. That is the main reason for what I did. Another, I guess, dislike is the way this feels so unguided. Gosh darn it. So just so you know, spikes are one-hit kills around here. I think I'm going the right way. It just feels very unguided in some ways. And, like, I get it, Metroidvania, you wander around, you find upgrades and unlocks access to new areas. But, like, from the beginning, it feels very open and wandery, and I think that's just because my abilities have been consistent. I haven't learned anything really new. I'm just as mobile as I've been all along. And, like, you know, with Metroid, where, oh gosh. So you don't want to hit those things because you're going to curse. Okay, good to know. Good to know. And you can't use items when you curse. Awesome. So, like with Metroid, again, where, you know, you need items to access new areas, like, it kind of restricts the playing field a bit before you can unlock those new areas. Also, but like in something like Blasphemous, which is also a really good Metroidvania, if you're into that kind of thing, I don't even know what I'm trying to say. It's kind of gory, but and it has kind of this twist on like Spanish Catholicism, I think. I'm not very well versed in that, so unfortunately I can't speak entirely to that. Sorry, I was hesitating because there's a boss fight here. But in that, there are multiple one-way gates that, like, it kind of hint at what's to come on the map, so you can see more of the world, but you know, oh, there's another way I have to get around this. And just by using the one-way gates, it can, like, not hinder your progress, but it can funnel you in, like, a sequence. Yeah, that's, I mean, I guess that's what I'm getting at with Metroid and Blasphemous, is that there are sequences to it. And yeah, people can sequence break and stuff, but there is an intended flow. And thus far with this, I have no idea what the intended flow is supposed to be at all. So that's just my nitpick for things. Overall, I would say this is a 5 out of 5 TWIT game, because even with my annoyances, it is so delightful. I enjoy it. You know, look at this. So cute. I am doing terribly. Oof. Oof-a-doof. I'd say, if you like, you like action platformers with good controls, you'll probably like this. Anything I mentioned earlier, but I mentioned Rogue Legacy, Dark Souls, what's the other ones? Blasphemous, Hollow Knight, they're not going to be as, gosh darn it. I knew it too. I knew that was going to happen too. Gosh darn it. Ugh. This is probably the best I've actually done with this fight, strangely enough. Because I haven't. Gosh darn it. Oof. So that spinny attack is going to be the death of me for sure. Yep. About to die. Doggone it. That's the lowest I've ever gotten her on health. Oh, wow. So yeah, if you like platforms with good responsive controls and challenging boss fights, maybe give this a try. Anything I mentioned earlier, but do recognize that it's different. Like, the Hollow Knight, cool, but it feels different. There are caveats, and I think I've basically talked about the caveats. Steam also recommends the as being similar, the Ori games, Dead Cells, and like 20XX, the roguelike Mega Man, which I can definitely see how all of those might be similar. But those are all my two playlists. I haven't gotten them yet, so I can't actually speak directly to that. But I don't know. I think with that, I'm going to go ahead and go. Gosh darn it. And hopefully not die to this boss, but we'll see. I'll see y'all next time. Bye. Well, that was unfortunate.